monthly salary of Dex is 1/4 of his father's monthly salary. Dex's sister's monthly salary is 2/5 of their father's monthly salary. So let's say, what is denominator here? Four parts. So let us take father's salary as 100%. Then Dex's salary becomes 100%. Sister's monthly salary is 2/5 of father's monthly salary. 2/5 of 400 is 160. So sister's monthly salary becomes 160%. Next, Dex's sister pays 12,800, which is 1/4 of her monthly salary. If 12,800 is 1/4 of monthly salary, then monthly salary 160% will be equal to 4 times of 12,800. Yes or no? Right. So 160% is equal to this much. Now, savings and expenses made out of the monthly salary by Dex is in the ratio 3:5. How much does Dex save every month? See, Dex monthly salary is 100%. If I take this as 5 parts, then this is 8 parts. Using 8 parts, how will you get 5 parts? Using 8 parts, how will you get 5 parts? Can I take 5/8 of that number? Yes or no? So, if you take 5/8 of sister's salary, which is 12,800, 4 times, then you will get Dex monthly salary. But you are asked to calculate savings of Dex. Savings of Dex are how many parts? 3 parts. Out of total, how many parts? So that is, again you need to calculate 3 out of 8. Yes or no? 8 into 8 denominator? 64. How many times? 2 times. And then 00. Yes or no? 4 into 200? 4 into 200, 800. 5 into 200? 5 into 200? 3 into 4? Answer? Done. Clear? Next. A sells an item at 20% profit to B. B sells it to C at 10% profit. C sells it to D at 116 rupees profit. Difference between cost price of D and cost price of A was 500. How much did B pay to A for the item? A sells it to B at what percent profit? 20%. So, selling price... Wait. Agandaka. A is selling the item to B at what percentage? At what percentage? 120%. B purchases the item from A at what percentage? So, we need to calculate 120%. 120% of cost price. Yes or no? 120 is 3 multiple? Yes. Answer should be 3 multiple. Yes. Is first option 3 multiple? No. Second option? No. Third option? No. Fourth option? No. Final answer. What? A, B, C, D. Let's say cost price of A is 100%. A sells it to B at 20% profit. That is 120%. B sells it to C at 10% profit, that is 132%, and C sells it to D at 116 rupees profit, that is 132% plus 116. Okay, and now you are given difference between cost price of D and A. D and A, how much is that? 32% plus 116, which is equal to 500. From this we will get 32%, and then we need to calculate 120%. Next, length of the rectangle is 4 meters more than the side of the square, and breadth of the rectangle is 4 meters less than side of the square. So length is 4 meters more and breadth is 4 meters less. If the side of the square is A, then length becomes A plus 4 and breadth becomes A minus 4. Area of the square is 567, which is A square. You are asked to calculate rectangle area. Rectangle area in the sense A plus 4 into A minus 4, which is A square minus 4 square. A square is this much, 4 square is 16, answer should end with 1. Last digit. 7 minus 6. Just observe only last digit. Answer should end with 1, 551 final. Don't try to calculate what is the value of A here. Area of the square, treat it as A square. Next. 16,000 was invested for 3 years, partly in scheme A at the rate of 5% per annum and partly in scheme B at the rate of 8% per annum simple interest. Right. At the rate of 5% per annum simple interest for 3 years, what is 15% of this number? What is 10%? 1600. 5%? 800. Total? 2400. Now, if the total money is given at scheme B, if the total money is given in scheme B, which offers 8% simple interest for 3 years becomes 24%. What is 10%? 1600. 20%? 3200. 2%? 320. 4%? 640. So 20% plus 4%, that is equal to 3840. 3840. If the total money is given in scheme A, we will get 2400, and if the total money is given in scheme B, we will get 3840. Okay, but what is total interest given in question? 3480. So 3480. Come on, difference. 360, and here 1080. What is the ratio? 1:3. So one part, three parts. Total how many parts we have? What is total money? 16,000. You're asked to calculate money invested in scheme A, which is equal to how many parts? One part. That should be? That's it. Done? Next. In a 140 liters of mixture of milk and water, the percentage of water is only 30%. Milkman gave 20 liters of this mixture to a customer. Out of total mixture, 20 liters is taken out. Total, we have 140 when 20 liters is taken out. Remaining quantity? See, when you take 20 liters from the mixture, even in 20 liters also, water will be 30%. And out of 140, if 20 liters is taken out, remaining quantity will be 120. Even in 120 liters also, water quantity must be 30%. Yes or no? What is 30% of 120? 36. If 36 liters of water is there out of 120 liters, remaining how much quantity we have? 84 liters. So 84 liters of milk and 36 liters of water we have. To this quantity, equal quantities of pure milk and water added. Let's say x liters added to both milk and water. Now the ratio is 2:1. That is 2:1. Go for cross multiplication. 84 plus x is equal to 72 plus 2x. Take x values to one side, that is x, which is equal to 84 minus 72. Answer 12. Next. A starts a business with a capital of 1500. B joins the business 6 months later from the start of the business, and C joins the business 8 months later from the start of the business. End of the year, their respective share in profit was in the ratio 5:3:3. What is the sum of amount put in the business by B and C together? See, out of total share, how much is A getting? And B getting? C also? A invested 1500 rupees for 12 months. Yes or no? Which is equal to how many parts? 5. How many times is 1500? 300 times into 12. Yes or no? In the same proportionate, 3 parts should be also equal to 3 into 300, that is 900 into 12. Yes or no? See what I am saying. A is getting 5 parts. As he invested 1500 rupees for 12 months. Yes or no? If 5 parts is equal to that much, with the same proportionate, I want to calculate 3 parts value. 5, 300 times into 12. Then 3 parts also should be equal to 3, 300 times into 12. Yes or no? That should be the investment and time period of B. Yes or no? B invested B number of rupees for 6 months. As he joined after 6 months. Got it? From this, 6 how many times? 6 how many times? 2 times. 900 into 2? So B invested 1800. Okay. C's investment is also equal to 3 parts, which is also equal to 900 into 12, which must be equal to C's investment multiplied by time period of C. C invested for 4 months as he joined after 8 months. 4 how many times is 12? 3 times. 900 into 3? 2700. That is investment of C. So total investment of B and C? 4500. Third option answer. Got it? Come on. If you don't understand, I'll repeat. Fine. A boat can travel 4.2 kilometers upstream in 14 minutes. 14 how many times is? 4.2? 0.3 times. Yes or no? 14 3 times is 42. But we have 4.2. That is 14.3 times. So that is covered in which stream? Usually we will measure speed in kilometer per hour. Hour in the sense how many minutes? See, for 14 minutes, if it can cover 4.2 kilometers, in 60 minutes in the sense, 60 into 0.3, that is 18 kilometers. So, upstream speed is equal to 18 kilometer per hour. Now, you are also given boat speed in still water and stream speed ratio, which is equal to 7:1. From the ratio, what is upstream? 6 parts. From the ratio, what is downstream? 8 parts. 6 how many times is 18? 3 times. 8 threes? So you know that downstream speed is equal to 24 kilometer per hour. Yes. But you are asked to calculate time to cover 17.6 kilometers in downstream. So downstream speed is equal to 24. You will get answer in hours. Hours converts to minutes. So into 60. 12 2 times. First of all, 17.6 is 11 multiple, answer should be 11 multiple, 44 final answer. Twelve five times sixteen. Two how many times? 8.8 times. Into 5 we have. 8.85 times in the sense 44. Fine. Next. A bag contains 5 red, 6 yellow and 3 green. Total 14 balls. 2 balls are picked at random. You can select in 14C 2 ways. Probability that either both are red. In how many ways can you select 2 red balls out of 5? 5C 2. Or both are green. Out of 3 green, you need to select 2. So 5C2 plus 3C2 by 14C2. Can you simplify that? What is your answer? 1 by 7. Okay. 10 men can finish a piece of work in 15 days. 8 women can finish the same piece of work in 25 days. Only 10 women started working and in few days completed certain amount of work. After that, 3 men joined them. The remaining work was completed by 10 women and 3 men together in 5 days. After how many days 3 men joined 10 women? Right. See, if 8 women can do it in 25 days, 1 woman can do it in 8 into 25 days? 1 day work is equal to 1 by 8 into 25? And 10 men can do it in 15 days. 1 man can do it in 10 into 15 days. 1 day work is equal to 1 by 10 into 15. Who started the work? Women. How many women? 10 women worked for some number of days, let it be X days. After that, 3 men joined. After 3 men joined them, still how many more days they are working? 5 days. In the sense, 10 women worked for X days and 5 more days. Work done by 10 women in 10 plus X days is 10 into X plus 5 by 8 into 25. And how many men join? 3 men join. And they worked for how many days? 5 days. And their work is equal to 3 into 5 by 10 into 15. And if 10 women worked for X plus 5 days and 3 men worked for 5 days, the work is completed. So which is equal to 1? Correct. 15, 15 cancel. So you have 1 by 10 in left hand side. Take that value to right hand side. 1 minus 1 by 10, that becomes? Come on, come on. 9 by 10. 10 into X plus 5 by 200. 825. 0, 0 cancel. 0, 0 cancel. So X plus 5 is equal to? 18. X is equal to? Third option. Are you done? At present, pi is 6 years older to Ray. Respect to ratio between present ages of pi and mini is 3 is to 4. Ray is 14 years younger to mini. What is Ray's present age? Right. First condition says, pi's age is 6 years older to Ray. Then, Ray's age will be pi's age minus 6. Yes or no? Right. From the ratio, what is pi's age? From the ratio, 3 parts. So 3 parts should be 3 multiple. From that again, if you subtract 3 multiple, then only you will get Ray's age. 3 multiple minus 3 multiple should be again 3 multiple. So out of options, you know that Ray's present age should be 3 multiple. This cannot be your answer, this cannot be your answer, this cannot be your answer. You are left with 2 options. Okay? Now, come again. Last condition. Ray is 14 years younger to Mini. And from the ratio, what is Mini's age? 4 parts should be 4 multiple. So from 4 multiple, if you subtract, younger anar kada? Mini's age is 4 multiple. Ray's age is 14 years younger to Mini's age. Where Mini's age is 4 multiple. 4 multiple minus 14. Is 14 4 multiple? When you subtract non-4 multiple from 4 multiple, will you get 4 multiple or non-multiple of 4? So 24 cannot be your answer. Because that is 4 multiple. 18 final answer. Got it? Next. Leda. These 3 are already eliminated. So, 2, the Ray's age, if you add 14 years, then you will get Mini's age. And Mini's age should be what multiple? 4 multiple. Now take second option. 24. 24 plus 14? Akka, 48 kadakka. 38. Is 38 4 multiple? This cannot be your answer. Final done. Need not to verify fourth option. 18 plus 14 is 32. 32 is a multiple of 4. Should be right answer. Okay. Next. That is 150 into 15? Yes or no? 15 square, 225 and then a 0 we have. So that becomes minus 2250. Let me take this negative number as 650. 650 and 2250. How much is that? 2900. How much will be there? 100. Yes or no? So 1441 by x is equal to 100, then x is equal to 1441 by 100, that is equal to 14.5, nearest number 15. Approximation, right? 57. 625. Under root 625. 20? 25 14 times. 25 10 times 250. 25 4 times 100. Total 350. Yes? And how much is this number? 20 into 16. 20 into 16? Total? 670. 6400 into 1 5 by 8 in the sense 13 by 8. 8 how many times? 800 13 times we have to calculate. 800 10 times? 800 3 times 2400. 8000 plus 2400. 10,000. Subtract 10,400 from the right hand side number. You will have 45. 44.8, that is 45. So 353 by x is equal to 45, then x is equal to 353 by 45. Answer should be definitely less than 10. Yes, yes or no? Yes. Cannot be 2 kada. ఇది ఇంటూనా ఐ థింక్ దట్ ఈస్ డివైడెడ్ బై రైట్ సో 8461 డివైడెడ్ బై 12 మైనస్ 24 ఇంటూ 100 బై 5 12 7 టైమ్స్ ఈస్ 84 12 700 టైమ్స్ ఈస్ 8400 and still you have 65 times. Total 705 minus 5 how many times? 20 times. 24 20 times? 480. 705 minus 480? 225. What is this? 680? And this one 15%? 15% is 10% plus 5%. 10% of 680, 5%, and you need to calculate 20% on 220. What is 10%? 22. 20%? 44. Total 146. Total expenses, and these are percentages of expenses made on two different departments, marketing and legal. You want me to explain? Time undi elagu. Marketing expenses of company D is less than marketing expenses of company B by approximately what percent? Approximately what percent? Okay. Right. Marketing D. D marketing what percent? 20% of 65. And B 23% of 80. Okay. Wait a minute. D is what percent less they are asking. Okay. Now D is 20% of 65 and the other one 23% of 80. Yes or no? 20 how many times? 4 times. So can I take this number as 65 by 92? Yes or no? Right. What is one third of denominator? Sorry, fine. Wait a minute. What is 10% of denominator? 9.2. How many approximate 9s are there? 7. So let's directly go for 70%. 10% is 9.2, 70% in the sense 9.2 into 7, that will be 64.4. Okay, yes or no? To make it 65, you need to add 0.6, that is not even 1%. So this value becomes 70% or 71%. In between 70 and 71%, if it becomes 70 to 71%, it is less by what percent? 29 to 30%. As your question is approximate, you can go for 30%, or if not 29. Which is there? 20. Direct. If it becomes 70%, it is less by 30%. Got it? Next. Otherwise, after 65 by 92, you have to take the difference. How much is the difference? 27. If D value is 65 and B value is 92, 65 is 27 less from 92 into 100. Next. What is the respective ratio between marketing expenses of A and marketing expenses of C? Yes or no? And 30% of 74. We have to calculate ratio. Wait a minute. Is 24 3 multiple?
Yes.
Is 30 3 multiple?
Yes.
Both 3 multiple gets cancelled?
Yes.
But still in numerator you have 90, which is 9 multiple?
Yes.
In denominator numbers, do we have any 3 multiple or 9 multiple?
No.
Then 9 multiple should be there in numerator itself?
Yes.
First option is the only one which is satisfying that. 36 is the only 9 multiple. 32 is not 9 multiple. This cannot be your answer. This cannot be your answer. This cannot be your answer. Got it? What is the average total expenses of all companies together? Average. Average. Benchmark. Observe options. Shall we go for 75? First number is 15 more. Next number 5 more. Next number 1 less. Next number 10 less. Next number 5 less. Total negative number 16. Total positive number 20. Still how much is left? 4 is adjusted among 5 companies. So each company again gets 0.8. So answer 75.8. If it is average, just benchmark. That's it. Total expenses of E in October 2012 was 20% more than total expenses of the same company in April 2012. So given information is April 2012. Now for E it is 20% more. How much was the marketing expenses of the same company in 2012 if it was 25% of total expenses? Right. Now in 2012, can I take this as 100%? Yes or no? If it increases by 20%, it becomes 120%? And 25% we need to calculate. 25% of 120 is what percent? 25% of 120, half and half, 30%. Yes or no? And we need to calculate 30% of 70. What is 10%? 7. 30%? Over. If the initial value is 100%, in October it becomes 120%. Out of 120, 25% is 1/4, which is 30%. So we need to calculate 30% of 70, which is 21. What is the difference between total expenses made by C in legal and marketing together and total expenses made by E in legal and marketing expenses together? Now, C, in both, what percent we have? 50. 5% of 74. Out of 74, what is 50%? 37. What is 5%? 3.7. Total 40.7. And E, ye kada? E what percent we have? 24% of 70. Right? Or 70% of 24? Out of 24, 50% is 12. Out of 24, 10% is 2.4. 20% is 4.8. Total 16.8. So other value is 16.8. You're asked about difference. Yes or no? Instead of 16.8, first subtract 16.7. If you subtract 16.7 from 40.7, how much will be there? 24. From 24, again you need to subtract 0.1. That is 23.9. Followed?